If you're curious what a data analyst or data scientist does on a day-to-day basis, this is the video for you. I've spent years working as a data analyst, managing analysts and data scientists, and working with people in these roles at other companies. I've summarized what you can expect in the day-to-day role, regardless of what company you're working at. So stay tuned to get all the details. I'm Jen with the Career Force. We help smart, career-minded people stand out in today's job market. We post new videos every week with all of the latest career insights. So subscribe and turn on notifications so you're the first to know the latest career news. Day-to-day work in data analysis jobs consists of three major things: process, data, and math. Now, there's lots of other details that go into the day-to-day work of this job or any other job, but these are the three core pieces that are going to take up 95% to 99% of your job. So let's look at each of them. Process. When I'm talking about process, I'm not just talking about the data analysis process, but I'm talking about the overall problem-solving process. Your real value to a company as a data analyst is being able to take a problem or a wanted outcome and figure out how to get from here to there. It's really kind of like a math proof where you're taking all of the things that you do know to find the answer to something that you don't know and explain something that you don't know. So the process involves all of the information gathering from the stakeholders that are presenting you with a problem that needs solved, to investigating what the real desired outcome is, not just what the question being asked is. All of these pieces go into that process. So this is probably going to involve meetings, whether it's one-on-one or in groups. It's going to be calling and talking to different people. This process piece also is going to be some amount of research, looking for if this has been addressed before or other pieces of information you might need as inputs. Now, the process piece is a lot of times mostly on the front end, but there's a key piece that happens on the back end as well. And that's how you communicate your analysis and results back to the people that need it or to the people that are going to make some sort of decision or take an action off of it. So within that process, it's how do you visualize the data? How do you communicate in whatever form necessary, whether it's written or in person? You need to be able to communicate well. And that's also part of that data process, that process step for an analyst. So on this process step, expect to spend about 20 to 30% of your time on this. In some cases, you may spend even longer. There is such a critical piece of the work that's about understanding what the problem really is and all of the necessary things that influence it to be able to make sure that the answer you provide is correct, and then providing that answer at the end of your analysis work. Once the problem is clear, you can move on to the data step of the work. So data is where you're going to spend probably 50 to 80% of your time. And this consists of three major things. It's gathering the data, cleaning the data, and processing the data. So depending on the problem you're working on and the company you're working at or with, the gathering the data may already be done for you for the most part. You may have easily accessible databases to go get all the information you need. In other cases, you might have to do this yourself. You might have to go to different stakeholders or go online and gather some market information to use as inputs to your analysis. Then you'll clean the data. So this is going through, it's understanding it. It's also making corrections where needed, removing outliers or things that shouldn't be included in the analysis. This can take a lot of time, but understanding all of this is really necessary before you start processing everything. So then the third step, processing the data. So this is actually going through and doing programming or using the different data tools that you have available to analyze the work. So again, most of your work as an analyst day to day is going to be spent on this part of the step. Then lastly is math. A lot of people go into analyst roles because they really like math. And that was the case for me as well. I really like math, but what I really like is the logic side. And so what I found is I really like data analyst work and the day-to-day activity, but most analysts don't do that much math. There's certainly math involved and mathematical principles involved in the day-to-day life of a data analyst, but a lot of the work is really more about the data and the process, and the math is maybe 10% of the actual work. Because you're really, your bigger challenge is to figure out how to solve the problem and then apply a little bit of math to solve the problem. And then you may also be setting things up so that it's repeatable. But this math step, while those skills are extremely useful, is going to be the smallest part of most data analyst jobs. So, do you have a better idea what a data analyst job consists of? If you work as an analyst today, I'm curious how the split at your job looks like. Is it the majority in the data side and the minority in the math side, or some other mix altogether? Let me know in the comments. Thanks so much for watching. I'll see you in the next video.